So the Joinery started very much as a passion project with my sister Natalie and I. Wanted to start something together as sisters, and at the same time wanted to ensure that our pillars were very focused on sustainability, eco-fashion, and really finding new ways and alternatives of producing our products and our clothing.
It's an organic and ethical fashion accessories and product brand based here in South Africa.
We started off with an amazing woman sewing cooperative in Manenberg. All these incredibly talented ladies who are very highly skilled, but due to the downturn of the manufacturing industry, they had no work.
We started outsourcing to our various different sewing cooperatives, about 17 different ladies and gentlemen. And since we started working with rPET, that number has increased within 1 year to 37. While we do concentrate heavily on who produces our clothing, we also concentrate very heavily on what our clothing and our products are produced from. We try to keep as much local as possible with all of our production, and that's why we decided to start entertaining an idea of, are there ethical and sustainable fabrics that we can look at conceptualizing here on South African soil.
We knew that we wanted to create products out of recycled matter, and particularly we have a major interest in plastics and recycling of plastics.
So when we approached PETCO, we really approached them with the idea that we wanted to conceptualize our own sustainable fabrics.
So it took a lot of research, it took a lot of time, it took a lot of technical input to find the right fabrics that we could use as a usable substrate for products and apparel. And with their help, we managed to get involved with a supplier who creates a fiber out of recycled plastic bottles. So whether it is something as simple as a tote bag or a laptop sleeve, to more interesting and creative ideas such as apparel, t-shirts made out of recycled plastic bottles, t-shirt dresses made out of recycled plastic bottles, caps, hats. And the general consensus is people are blown away when we tell them, you know, this t-shirt that you're wearing is made out of recycled plastic bottles that otherwise would have gone to landfill.
And for us, it makes us proud as a business that we can conceptualize and get fabrics here on African soil.
So thank you, PETCO, for broadening our horizons and, you know, sort of guiding us to where we are today.
So since we started working with rPET, which was May 2016, up to this point across all the different projects and clients that we've worked with, we've managed to keep up to this point 15,000 plastic bottles out of landfill. And with our future projects, which we already have on the go, we expect that number to increase drastically.
Well, I think as creatives, we actually have a huge responsibility to take our skill set and innovative ideas and channel them into the right direction. And there are so many creatives, not only in fashion and product, but we're talking across the board, whether it's industrial designers. People are creating for the future. So it's vital that creatives all start thinking about our action, our choices, and it's simple choices that can make a difference.
For me, if we don't have passion and we don't have the drive towards a sustainable business, then what do we have? And I feel we have that. So I think it would be extremely incredible to be able to celebrate the fact that as a fashion and product brand that we are placing so much emphasis on sustainability. It may be the hard route and the route less traveled, but we have pledged to continue on the journey.